Move! Hey, you're okay, girl. Damn. Here we go. You okay?
Help!
You sick, partner?
It's in me. They're in me.
You're not well, friend.
Butcher's Creek. Butcher's Creek.
Where?
Butcher's Creek.
Is that where you're from?
Butcher's Creek.
You want me to take you back, or?
They're in me.
Come on, let me get you home.
Butcher's Creek. Golly, boxes.
The darkness.
Some distress. Yeah, he seems calmer now. I found him out in the woods.
Oh, Lemuel. Sweet Lemuel. Such a nice man. Such a good man. Come here. No, come on. Get up here. I'll help you. Since the troubles began, he's not the same.
It's in me.
Why is he looking at me funny?
No, he's not well. It's the darkness. He said it's the darkness.
Who says it's the darkness?
Well, the village is... Well, thank you, sir. Thank you for... please. Lemuel, not well.
You got anything for me?
Oh, yeah. Of course, sir. Love and friendship in darkness. What else are there? Obadiah Hinton, that's me.
Yeah.
Love and friendship. Friendship and love. We're not a rich village, sir. But with love, rich. We thank you.
Okay.
Dear sir, you were once very kind to Beau and myself, and it pains me to ask you to show us further kindness. But I have nowhere else to turn, and nobody else upon whom I can impose. I will, of course, pay you handsomely for your troubles. My family have turned quite mad and are threatening to send me away to stop my work, which they say is disgracing them. As if their history of absolute moral depravity, utter debauchery, and perpetual drunkenness did not disgrace them enough. I must escape, yet I am kept prisoner here. Can you help? Most days I am to be found at the cabins on the plantation, the main house and all its...
Hello, Mr. Morgan.
Let's go, girl. Thank you. Difference now. If an outlaw or a wild animal doesn't get me starvation. We came out here from the city in search of a different life. Something true, something real. All this wandering and indulgence, we wanted to strip it away, to find something authentic. What a pair of fools.
Is there a train station or a town I can take you to?
No, I can't give up now. He wouldn't want that. I can't have it. I'm gonna do this for you.
Do it. Is there anything left for you to eat?
Nothing. No, we didn't know the first thing about hunting. Couldn't even catch a darn mouse. Do you need any poisonous berries, though? I'm a natural at finding those.
Well, you ain't gonna last much longer out here if you don't know how to hunt. Come on. I'll show you.
All right. But you better not try any funny business. You know, I may be weak, but I still know how to stand up for myself.
Oh, I don't doubt it. Come on. Tell me, you ever skin an animal before?
No, but then again, I haven't caught much of anything either.
Well, you'll need to know how to do both if you're gonna survive out here.
I am all... ...but you were aware. So where should we head for?
Let's try in the trees down there, near the river. What happened to your husband, if you don't mind me asking?
A bear got him. He was horrified. He survived, but only for a couple of days. I buried him a week ago.
I'm sorry.
This was really his dream more than mine. I'd have hopped the next train back to Chicago if he'd said the word. But now, I don't know, it's hard to explain. I have to do this.
I understand. Yes. This is a good spot.
There. Look. Rabbit. Okay, stay quiet and still watch me.
Get your hands dirty.
How do I mean, what do I do?
Just hold the legs tight and pull the skin away quickly. Should come right off. That's it. Go on.
It worked.
That is all there is to it. You did good.
I think I've seen enough blood for one day. Do you mind if we head back now?
Sure. I'll walk you back. You did good. That should keep you fed for a few days.
I'd be dead now.
You got a rifle?
Yes. Well, my husband's.
I suggest you learn how to use it. Now, come on, let's get you home.
Since we got here, it feels like every step forward has come with 100 steps back. People always talk about the simplicity of country life, but there's nothing simple about any of this. I'm sure you're in a rush to get going.
Well, I guess we only know what we know.
Oh, please. I'm sure it wouldn't take you too long to adjust to a life of privilege and indolence in the big city.
I don't know about that. It sounds awful.
Oh, it is. A truly empty and boring existence. But an undeniably easy one. I still can't believe he's gone. Thank you. That was the first time anyone's done anything nice for us. For me. Since we got here.
Well, nature provides, but she sure don't always make it easy.
That she doesn't. I'd invite you in, but I'm dead on my feet, if you'll forgive the pun. Please do call again sometime, though. A good rest, and hopefully I'll be a new woman.
You take care, ma'am.
Thank you.
Come on, girl.
That could liquefy each of your internal organs in turn and leave you just a puddle on the floor.
Professor, I ain't here to rob you. It's me. I helped you at the pond.
You did? Oh, you did. The buffoon. Hello.
Hello.
I hope I'm not disturbing you.
Of course you are disturbing me, buddy. I almost solved biggest problem and you mess it up!
Did?
No, but I did. I can't get the bloody conductor straight. The geometry of life. The grand theory of power. It's the grand theory of theories. There is just one more big problem. Maybe I solve it, but I can't get it right.
I don't understand.
Of course you don't. Help me adjust these things, and I will show you what I mean. Here, take these.
I'm not much of a scientist.
Yeah, well, you are an American. Science is far beyond you, but you make a fine buffoon. Go.
Thank you.
wish I ever went to school so I had a clue what was going on. What now?
Well, now, I become the second creature after God himself to bring life to this earth. Like this!
Am I missing something?
The switches. The bloody switches. Okay. Climb up there and adjust them for me. Go quick, please. This is my life's work. It is incredible. What? I am so oh, you just saw creation's second birth.
I just saw a machine waddle a few steps.
I have a son. I am the luckiest man alive. Those morons, they doubted me.
I'll see you later.
Yes, yes. Goodbye.
Oh. With you.
What's your problem?
What the hell's the matter?
I said hell, even the blind hog finds an acorn every once in a while.
Hey, you want company, boy?
This is town.
Go away. Just go away.
I'm sorry. I'm really sorry, but I... Well.
Well, you're sorry. Yeah, I heard you.
But, I mean... Well, this country is man unleashed. That's the thing. And it ain't my fault any more than it is anyone else.
Man unleashed? Then unleash goodness. Not just hell's feeble brothers, sir.
But how? I mean, all I know how to do is fight, I guess. I was set free to fight. Where's your son, Mrs. Down?
Where you think? Down the mine. Until he gets sick. Which won't be long, given how hard they work him. See, foemen don't like him, so he gets the worst of it.
Maybe I could go with
him. Maybe you could just leave us all alone. Maybe. Maybe you could just go fight some other battle.
Thank you.
boy.
Be quiet, Mr. Dockery.
Oh, your mom's a whore and that's a goddamn fact.
Why don't you shut up?
Oh, all right.
Who's this, your daddy?
My daddy died. And this man, he killed him. What are you doing here?
Leave the boy alone.
Why'd you kill his daddy? You after his mama?
Stop bullying the boy.
Get out of my business, mister.
Leave the boy alone.
Or what?
I'll kill you too.
You couldn't kill no one. Look at you, all ragged and sick and weak. Clear off, you goddamn hermit. Clear off! You and the horse son here.
Let the boy go. Let him go! Come with me. Shame on you. He's just a goddamn boy! Let's get you out of here.
But they're gonna kill me. Now I got no job and they're gonna kill me.
I've got some money. You and your mama can go someplace nice.
Well, why are you doing this?
I don't know. Listen, take this. All of it. Try and talk to your mama and get out of here. Now run.
I'll try.
Good boy. I don't want to see you here again. Morning, dear.
Morning.
Morning, sir.
Morning.
Howdy-o.
Stupid man.
Mr. Morgan.
Herr Strauss.
How are you?
About how I look.
Okay. Are you perhaps available for some work?
Debtors?
Yes.
I guess.
Your commitment to your duties is admirable. You know, Mr. Morgan, you are... Well, I'm sorry for you. Hmm? No, never mind. I didn't...
Look, Strauss.
You take care.
I ain't dead yet.
No, of course not. That's what I was saying.
A debtor, Strauss. Who owes you money?
Well, there's a deserter from Fort Wallace. Head to him first. They're looking for him out on the road near Three Sisters. Man's name is J. John Weathers.
J. John Weathers.
Then there's a miner over in Annisburg. He's called Arthur. Like you. Huh. Arthur Londonderry. Family man, desperate, you know the type.
Couldn't one of the boys do this?
I tried. They lacked your... vigor.
Vigor, huh? All right.
Take care, Mr. Morgan.
Morning, Arthur.
Things are gonna be okay, Jack.
Can I go play in the caves?
No. I ain't safe in there. Come on, the girl. Okay, then. Thank you. girl.
J. John Weathers.
They call me Snow Goose now.
Whatever they call you. You borrowed money off of Leopold Strauss. The bills come due.
This ain't the best time, sir.
This ain't the best time for anyone.
Mr. Strauss knew it was a long-term proposition.
The debt is due.
Okay. I got supplies meant to last through the winter. You can take them, just... Is there any way you can help me? I stay out here, there won't be anyone to pay you.
I ain't here to help. I'm here to collect. We're all of us up against it.
Look, there's men after me. They're killers. I ain't a deserter, just an objector. It ain't right. If there was another way than running, I need your help.
Shut up.
Please. I...
Up here, it's him.
It's too late.
Form up, we shoot on sight.
I clear off, sir.
Shit! Well, seeing as I'm here, I'll do what I can for you. The damn wagon.
We could probably still save something.
Really now?
Look, you can take the silver locket for the debt.
Damn the debt. Just get her somewhere safe. Go on.
Thank you, fella. You know, there ain't enough kindness in this world, that's for sure. But you...
I don't know nothing about cows.
Oh.
Can you help? Can you help me, mister?
What's the problem?
My goddamn horse got spooked and run off.
Are you hurt?
Not too bad, at least. But he took my damn leg.
Sorry.
He went that way, I think. His name's Buell.
Buell?
Second time a prick named Buell cost me a leg.
Huh?
Buell was my general when I lost it.
Okay.
Anyway, if you see an angry bastard of a horse with my wooden leg, I'd be real grateful.
I'll bear that in mind. Spooked, all right.
Whoa, now, easy. Take it easy, there.
There, boy. Come on, Dan. Let's get you back. Yeah, he's just where you left him. Can't go far with that leg in your stirrup. Can't go bucking him like that. So you better be good, you hear? I get the notion he's not a man you want to cross. No matter how big and strong you are. Spook you here. Come on. You're not so nasty. I found him.
You're a good man, mister. Mr.
Arthur. You're right. He's a brute.
Hamish Sinclair. Yeah, he's a great horse. Aside from when the devil got him. Hey, you wanna hand me that leg there, please? And while you're at it, give old Buell a kick for me, would you?
No, I'm only kidding.
Thank you. Warren, but a snake that spooked him. You're a real gentleman, you know?
Sometimes, maybe. How'd you lose a leg?
Oh, in the war. Cannonball. Pretty clean, though. I don't have much pain, and I didn't get any gangrene. A young boy went into battle with me, got cut in half, so all things considered, I'm doing pretty well, I guess.
Yeah, I guess. So, how is the false one?
It's okay. I can still hunt, fish, enjoy the outside. Weren't sent too crazy by it. Anyway, I ain't got much to pay you with.
You know, that's okay.
You like fishing? You can come with me someday. I know some pretty good spots.
I'm a pretty poor fisherman.
Yeah, well, I'm great, so between the two of us, we do okay. My cabin's right over on the other side of O'Cray's Run there. Thanks again. You throw me again, you old dumb bastard, I'm gonna put a bullet in you. I'll see you again.
Thank you.